All right, here's a quick lesson on how to play Viva la Vida from one of my absolute favorite bands, Coldplay. There isn't actually a lot of traditional guitar playing in that song, but that doesn't mean that you can't play something pretty close to what all the string parts and keyboard parts are doing. So I'll just show you, there are really just a couple of variations on the same four chords throughout the entire song. Pretty much the same strumming pattern. Articulated strumming pattern, and that's it. So here we go. The strumming pattern for most of the whole song is I just use all downstrokes, and it's just. So through most of the song, it's just repeated over and over and over again. You hear it the whole time. We'll do something a little bit different during the chorus to approximate all of the other parts that come in. But you're just going to apply that strumming pattern to these basic four chords. The first chord, well, to start with, we're putting a capo on the first fret. And everything will go from there. You don't have to put a capo on the first fret to play this song, but it'll make things easier for everybody. So here's the first thing we do. We're going to play what's going to look like a C chord. It's going to look like a C position. I'm going to refer to all the numbers as the original numbers. So forget the capos there. I'm just going to talk the original numbers. Forget about the capo. When I say the third fret, I mean the actual third fret. Okay? So for this first chord, we're going to go ring finger, fourth fret on the A string, C sharp. Fourth fret on the A string, ring finger. Okay? Now your ring finger is gonna, you're just gonna wanna lean it back just slightly, lean it towards the fretboard so that it mutes the D string. Okay? You don't wanna hear the D string. Okay? And then you're gonna play the G string open and the B string open. Okay, and you don't want to play either the low E or the high E. You want those strings to not ring at all. So you got the fourth fret on the A string with your ring finger, mute the D by leaning your finger back, G and B open. Okay, so you got three strings, three notes coming out. Okay, the next chord, very simple. You just take your ring finger off. You're going to start on the D string. The D string is open. G string is open. And you're going to go second fret on the B string with your index finger. Okay, first chord was. Second chord is. Okay, third chord, even easier. Just take your index finger off. And you're gonna go D, G, and B, all open. Just those three strings. Okay, so far we have. All open. D, G, and B. Okay, and then also very simply for the last chord, we're just gonna take our, well, middle finger, or really any whatever finger you want, and we're gonna play the third fret on the D string, then the G is open, and the B is open, and again, those are the only three strings you're gonna play. Third fret with whichever finger you like on the D string, open G, open B, and that's it. Okay, so when you take those four chords, and then you apply the strumming pattern to them, you get this. Okay, now if you are more advanced and you prefer to not, have the sound of the open strings with the capo or whatever, you can, work it out and play it up higher. you prefer that sound. But for everybody else, we'll just do it down here. Okay. Now, the only thing we're going to do to get through the rest of the song is we're just going to make slight variations on those four chords. Okay, so for example, when we get to after the first verse, we're going to change it to this, okay? It's really just the note on top of each chord is what's going to become important when we make these little changes. Okay, so after the first verse, we're going to go to this. Same beginning of this first chord we have, okay? Just finger like you're on that first chord, okay? Except for now, we're going to take our index finger, put it on the second fret, on the B string, okay, and then our pinky we're gonna put up on the fourth fret on the high E string. So now we're gonna have fourth fret on the A, mute the D, open G, second fret on the B, fourth fret on the high E. Okay. That high note is what's going to be important. Okay, and then the next chord, you just pretend like we're on the second chord we had originally, except for now you're going to take your middle finger, put it on the third fret on the high E string. Okay, so we've gone from two. Okay, now we're going to go back to this on the top. Okay, so we had, the third chord we had originally was D, G, and B open. Okay, now we're just going to take our pinky, pretty much just because it was already there, or your ring finger, or whatever finger you want, really, on the fourth fret, on the high E string, we're going to add it to the D, G, and B open. Okay, so we've had... Now for the fourth chord, whereas before we had D string, third fret, open G, open B, we're going to do the same chord, we're just going to add the third fret on the high E string on the top. You can finger that however you want, whatever is most comfortable for you. So now we've had, listen to the highest note, that's what's important about that, that's what we've changed. So when you hear that, you got... And you got to remember, when you're doing these strums, you want to get it real articulate and short and cut off, okay? So every time I strum it, and then my right hand comes back down. I strum down, and my hand comes back up to it. And on my left hand, okay, in order to help that articulation as well, I play. Any stray fingers I have, as soon as I play the chord, they're coming down on the strings. Now they're not making a noise. Whenever you do